This is Caleb with Hackaday. I'm here in Nashville, Tennessee at the Hacker Consortium, and Skydog here has agreed to give us a tour. Excellent. All right.
Well, this is our 12-seat learning lab. It's a little out of sorts. We shuffled some things around just recently, so we've got to put it all back in nice, even rows. We'll 12 stations, PCs with screens and everything there, complete with chairs, projector behind us, multimedia system, the whole nine yards, so we can host classes in here, or we're doing soldering or things like that in a classroom setting. We have the space for it. If we'll go this way, we step into the kitchen area, or a portion of it. A little bit of everything here. Hookah, adult libations, things of that nature. We're really big on beer and things of that ilk. Come on through. We've one of the things, we rebuilt the bathroom. I would suggest that anyone who has a hackerspace have a nice bathroom and at least have a shower. It's very, very helpful.
So, yeah, that's nice.
We come into the main kitchen area. The cabinets and everything we have here were all hand-built by Mudflap. You have the HC and the backsplash there. That was, it's always good to have somebody who's very good at procuring. You cannot get a small number of tiles in that color red without, you know, finagling or buying a full case. So he's in charge of our procurement. He got our little backsplash going on there.
Very nice.
We have a lounge area. It's one of the last areas of the space that we've been working on. As in, we've been working on it for about a year and a half. We just haven't had a chance to finish everything out yet, but we're talking about having gaming screens and things like that in there. Large screen stuff.
Fun.
So we'll step downstairs into the warehouse area. We have Mudflap, our intrepid acquirer.
Greetings.
He's trying to hide the beer, actually. But anyway, so we have lockers. It's one of our standards. We published locker standards to fit into the racks. We gave you an external size, and you were the one that had to figure out how to actually put everything together and make it fit inside the space. The key being, when you put it in, they're not easy to get out if someone else packs things on top of yours, so when you put it in, make sure it's done right the first time.
Wow, we have light.
This is our server room. It's a little bit loud, but it serves a purpose. We have one rack that's nothing but production equipment for the consortium itself, along with surveillance and things of that nature. Some VMware stuff working in there. We have another rack that's specifically for members to use. So basically anyone who wants to put a server, we've got 5 static IPs, they can play around. You can set up the networking however you like. We have a third empty rack because we haven't had that many people fire up a server yet. And then a 16 kVA, this is the 10 kVA UPS full of lead acid batteries that will run this room for approximately an hour and a half if the power happened to go out. In the backside behind the UPS is a full RFID access control system that takes care of all the access control issues we might have getting in and out of the building, air conditioning and fun things in here. That's why it's extremely loud. Appreciate that. This is sort of the main work warehouse area. It's a delightful mix of messed up and dirty, but it works. We have about 24 linear feet of work table surface here. We found we used to have them broken out, individually tabled, and looking at all the other hackerspaces, we found that everyone preferred sort of a community feel. One long table, everyone sat around, you could eat. Easier to talk to people, you didn't have to walk in and out of the tables. So I think it was NYC Resistor was one of the main places we saw this at. So we changed it around, made it more community seating. We have the requisite snack machine with no snacks, which works really well. Of course, surveillance, all cameras all over the outside of the building. That way, when you knock on the door, we know who's there. We don't have to worry about that. Everyone needs a 36-inch wide laser printer. Those It's interesting some of the things you can collect like that. Color printer. Everyone needs an electronic piano. One of our members is actually going through and putting electronic pickups in it. So it's either going to work or we're going to blow it up, so take your pick. Lots of other fun things. One of our members has done some boxing before, so he brought his heavy bag in, and we've been known to pull it down and actually do a little bit of heavy bag work, work out some stress in the office. We have sort of the Hackerspace standard, the 40-watt FS laser, their sort of standard package. I suggest everyone who wants to do any kind of rapid prototyping and play with acrylic, this is the thing to go with. It's about $3,000, a little bit of finagling to get things like that, but definitely worth it. Tools on the wall, this is originally our main tool bench. They've kind of migrated all over the place. People have a tendency to pick it up and lay it down somewhere else. So we have a lot of the woodworking machines over here in the middle, drill press, saw, lathe, table saw. Be careful with table saw, these fingers, that kind of thing. We did a lot of shelving on the when we first got into the building up front to be able to put all our raw materials, monitors. One of the things we found is people are very very happy to give you all of their old crap, whether you like it or not.
Oh yeah.
And unfortunately you'll collect it in a lot of ways and have to go through and sort it on a regular basis. But lots of shelving worked out pretty well for us. And then that's, I guess on the other side, we've got a couple of things here. I'll get to brag on Mudflap for a minute. A good sink. We found a stainless steel sink, which none of us has taken a bath in it yet, but I think a few of us would actually fit into it. Another recommended item to have, wire-fed welder. We have the, everyone needs the shopping cart chair. This is one of the more comfortable chairs in the building. I've been told that the shopping cart came from a broken home, and then we gave it a place to stay, so it was all perfectly legal and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
So, and then one of the problems we had originally was heat. We got a one of the forced heat or forced fuel heaters from Home Depot, but the trouble is it goes through a fair amount of fuel. So what we ended up doing, Mudflap took a gas water heater tank, gutted it, put an access hatch in it, and a piece of stovepipe on the top, and it's actually a waste oil heater. So it's got a small needle valve on the back and a drip tube, which goes into a probably about a 6-inch diameter aluminum plate on the bottom with a taper. It takes a little bit of kerosene, paper towel or two, a little bit of oil to get it started. Once it starts, the outside skin will get to about 500 or 600 degrees. So if you heat the space originally with a fuel, force fuel heater, you'll get it up to temperature enough to make it comfortable, and this will sustain it for the rest of the day. And let's face it, who doesn't have enough waste oil sitting around if you have a car?
Yeah.
So it worked well for us. Made it where we could heat the place without breaking the bank, which is entirely possible to do. And toolboxes, boxes of stuff, that's pretty much it.
All right, great. Well, thank you very much for the tour.
Absolutely, anytime.